Greetings to all. Under the section Pharmacology, we will be studying about psychoactive drugs. Aim of the study is to understand why one gets addicted to the drugs, its mechanism in brief, and some of the examples of drugs of abuse. In pharmacology, a drug is defined as a chemical substance of known structure and property which, when administered to a living organism, produces a biological effect. It is also called legal drug or medicine. A legal or medicinal drug, however, can be harmful and addictive if misused. An illegal drug means it is forbidden by law as it can cause ill effects on an individual. Addiction is a neurological disorder that affects the reward system in the brain. Reward system is a neurotransmitter known as dopamine. In a healthy person, the reward system emphasizes important behaviors that are essential for survival, such as eating, drinking, and social interaction. For example, the reward system ensures that you reach for the food when you are hungry, because you know that after eating, you will feel good. In other words, it makes the activity of eating pleasurable and memorable. So you would want to do it again and again whenever you feel hungry. Drugs of abuse hijack the system, turning the person's natural needs into drug needs. We shall look into how the messages are communicated in the brain. The brain consists of billions of neurons or nerve cells which communicate via chemical messages or neurotransmitters. When a neuron is sufficiently stimulated, an electrical impulse called an action potential is generated and travels down the axon to the nerve. Here, it triggers the release of neurotransmitter into the synaptic cleft, a space between neurons. The neurotransmitter then binds to the receptor on the neighboring neuron, generating a signal in it, thereby transmitting the information to that neuron. This causes dopamine release from the neurons into the synaptic space. Dopamine then binds to and stimulates the dopamine receptor on the receiving neuron. This stimulation by dopamine is believed to produce the pleasurable feeling or rewarding. Dopamine molecules are then removed from the synaptic space and transported back into the transmitting neuron by a special protein called dopamine transporter. So once the dopamine re-enters into the transmitting neuron through the dopamine transmitter, the pleasure wears off. So this phenomenon occurs in each and every individual. This is a natural phenomenon. But what about the cases in a drug abuse? In drugs of abuse, there is an increase in the level of dopamine. Some drugs such as alcohol, heroin, and nicotine indirectly excite the dopamine producing neuron so that they generate more action potential. For example, if you see in this picture, the mechanism of cocaine, cocaine acts at the nerve terminal. It binds to the dopamine transporter and blocks the reuptake of dopamine. So now what happens? The dopamine cannot enter back into their vesicles. They just remain in the synaptic cleft. So a person who is under the influence of cocaine, what happens? There is more of dopamine. In other words, we can say that there is more of pleasure or more of reward. There is another drug called as methamphetamine. Here what happens? It is a psychostimulant. It acts similarly to cocaine. So in addition to cocaine, what it does is it can enter into the neuron, into the dopamine containing vesicles. Once it enters into the dopamine containing vesicles, that is through, it enters through the dopamine transporter, it sends a signal to the dopamine telling that, come on, you get released. So now what happens? The dopamine containing vesicles will get triggered and the dopamine releases even in the absence of the action potential. This causes a continuous stimulation, maybe for overstimulation of receiving neurons, and it is responsible for a prolonged and intense euphoria experienced by the drug users. Repeated exposure to dopamine surges caused by the drugs eventually desensitizes the reward system. The system is no longer responsive to everyday stimuli. The only thing that is rewarding is that drug. That is how drugs change the person's life priority. After some time, even the drug loses its ability to reward, and higher doses are required to achieve the rewarding effect. This ultimately leads to drug overdose. The four types of psychoactive drugs are depressant, like drugs like alcohol or analgesics slow down the activity of a central nervous system and thus cause us to become less alert. They are also often used to addicts to relieve their stress and be able to relax. Then we have stimulants like caffeine, nicotine, which increases the activity of our brain and make us feel more energetic and aroused. We have opioids like heroin and pain medication, hallucinogens like LSD. In the following slides, we shall look into some of the examples of drugs of abuse. Hallucinogens, drugs like LSD and magic mushroom, lead us to see reality in distorted forms. We may also start seeing or hearing things which are not there at all. Magic mushrooms are wild or cultivated mushrooms that contain psilocybin, a naturally occurring psychoactive compound. Magic mushrooms are sold in international market as dried brown mushrooms or as crude mushroom preparation. Another alkaloid, mescaline, is native to Mexico and Mexican Indians used it for religious ceremonies. It is dried and refined to get a white to brown powder. Club drugs are also sometimes used as date rape drugs. Example, ketamine. Ketamine usually appears as a clear liquid or a white to off-white powder. These drugs are very powerful. Someone could put one in your drink when you are not looking. They can affect you very quickly and you might not know that something is wrong. The length of the time of the effects last varies. It can also induce amnesia, making it difficult to recall events that took place while under the influence. It depends on how much of the drug is in your body, and if the drug is mixed with other drugs or alcohol, it can make the effect of the drug even stronger and can cause serious health problems like urinary infection, bloody urine, and even death. So be very aware. Never leave your drink unattended. Don't accept drinks from other people. If drinking from a can or bottle, open your drink yourself. Actually, ketamine was developed in early 1960s and it was used in human and veterinary medicine as primarily as anesthesia. Heroin, it's an opioid drug made from morphine, a natural substance in the seed pot of the Asian poppy plant. Like any other drug, heroin is injected into the vein. It can be snorted, sniffed, and smoked depending mainly on the purity of the drug and the user. Sniffing involves inhaling the drug into the lower part of the nostril, while snorting sucks the drug into the upper part of the nostril. Straws or rolled up dollar bills are typically used to snort the drugs. Heroin comes in a powder or a tar-like form, so in its natural state it cannot be directly injected into the body. It must be changed into the liquid form first. In 1898, pharmaceutical giant Bayer marketed heroin, the most addictive of substances, as a non-addictive substitute for morphine and a cough. Because at the point in the history, pneumonia and tuberculosis claimed a lot of life. So the world desperately needed a remedy that would suppress coughing, and heroin perfectly fitted the bill. Its sedative and pain-killing effects also provided great relief for TB and pneumonia sufferers. Naturally, heroin became quite popular remedy until people started getting addicted to it. The drug rapidly fell out of favor and was eventually outlawed everywhere. People usually begin to experience a feeling of euphoria within 7 to 8 seconds. When it is smoked, its peak effect is 10 to 15 minutes. People who inject drugs are at high risk of HIV and hepatitis. This does not mean that those who smoke or snort heroin are free of risk. They are also at increased risk of HIV and AIDS and hepatitis because they are more likely to have unprotected sex while they are under the influence. This slide shows you the picture of poppy plant from where heroin is extracted. And the other side you can see the cocoa plant wherein the active ingredient is cocaine. So cocaine, it is also known as coke, crack, rock, C, Charlie. Most of these drugs, you know, they have this nicknames. So cocaine, it speeds up the activity of certain chemicals in the brain and makes us feel less tired and more alert. Cocaine is manufactured from the cocoa plant, which grows naturally in Bolivia and Peru. Traditionally, Peruvian Indians used to chew its leaf to lessen the fatigue caused by living at high altitudes. Did you know that this cocaine hydrochloride was one of the ingredients used by Coca-Cola until 1930? Cocaine is a white powder. It can be snorted up the nose or mixed with water and injected with needle. Cocaine can also be made into small white rocks called crack. Crack is smoked in small pipe. Cocaine speeds up your whole body. You may feel full of energy, happy and excited, but then your mood can change. You can become hangry, nervous and afraid that someone is out to get you. You might do things that make you no sense. After the high of the cocaine wears off, you can crash and feel tired and sad for days. You also get a strong craving to take the drug again to try feel better. In the slide at the bottom, you can see a person smoking crack, which is a form of cocaine, and he uses the small glass pipe to smoke. Okay. Some of the most common serious problem in consuming cocaine is the heart attack and stroke. You also are at a risk of HIV, AIDS, hepatitis from sharing needle or having unsafe sex. Cocaine is more dangerous when it's combined with other drugs or alcohol. But remember that cocaine has a very good medical uses. For instance, we can see that though it is an illegal when it is used in the recreational drug, it does have a legitimate medical uses. It has both anesthetic and vasoconstrictive property. That is, it can contract the smooth muscles of the blood vessels, which makes it ideal for some medical purpose. And also it is used for upper respiratory procedures, for topical use in the form of cocaine hydrochloride. Topical use means that you can apply on the surfaces of your skin. Marijuana or cannabis. Marijuana is a green, brown or gray mix of dried, crumbled parts from marijuana plant. The main psychoactive chemical in marijuana responsible for intoxicating effect is delta-9-tetrahydrocannabinol, THC. Marijuana can cause the heartbeat to increase by 20 to 100% and reduce the blood pressure. An overdose can cause paranoia and hallucination. Paranoia means persistent feeling that people are out to get you. People who smoke large amounts of cannabis on regular basis have reduced bone density, which can increase the risk of bone fractures. It can cause burning and stinging of mouth and throat and cause heavy coughing. And they are 3 more times likely to develop cancer of head or neck. Marijuana plant has chemicals, cannabinoids, that can help with some health problems. The FDA has approved 2 drugs that contain THC. These drugs treat nausea caused by chemotherapy in cancer patients and to increase appetite in patients who have severe weight loss from AIDS or cancer. There is also a liquid drug that contains cannabinoids. It treats 2 forms of severe childhood epilepsy. Epilepsy is a central nervous system disorder in which brain activity becomes abnormal, causing seizures or periods of unusual behavior, sensations, and sometimes loss of awareness. Still, there remains concern over the effects of THC. This is due to the fact that it can have stimulating effects in some people, which may lead to other side effects. Thus, when considering cannabis for any medical condition, your doctor will likely assess whether the anti-inflammatory benefits outweigh any psychological risks. Methamphetamine, or in short it is called as meth or crystal meth, it is a very addictive stimulant drug. It is a powder that can be made into a pill or a shiny rock called crystal. The powder can be eaten or snorted. It can also be mixed with liquid and injected into the body with a needle. Crystal meth is smoked in a small glass pipe. It has many nicknames: meth, crank, chalk or speed. Meth can quickly lead to addiction. It causes medical problems including making your body temperature so high that you pass out, severe itching, meth mouth, that is broken teeth and dry mouth, thinking and emotional problems. Meth at first causes a rush of good feelings, but then users feel edgy, overly excited, angry or afraid. Crystal meth is noted for causing horrific scarring in users, as you see in the slide. But these scars come after a long period of using the drug. There's a street drug called Croctel. This is a mix of lethal pills, petrol, cooking oil and lighter fluid. Literally, this causes the skin of its users to rot in record time. Eventually, users will be left with skin that quite resembles that of a crocodile, which is probably where the drug got its name, some of which have a shocking effect on the person's physical appearance. With these few examples, we would like to ask a question: is it easy to come out of drugs? The answer is no. The person will have withdrawal effect. Different drugs and substances will have different withdrawal symptoms and timelines depending on how they interact with the brain and body. Drugs are observed and remain active in the body for differing amount of times. This is often referred to as drugs half-life, which relates to the different withdrawal timelines for each substance. The severity and duration of withdrawal is influenced by the level of dependency on the substance and few other factors, including the length of the time abusing the substance, type of substance abused, method of abuse, amount taken each time, family history and genetic makeup, medical and mental health factors. To conclude, it is better to keep away from illegal drugs. One should only use medication prescribed by a doctor. For those who have someone close who is a drug addict, it is important to keep an eye on the person and call an ambulance immediately if they seem to be in danger. It might also be helpful to learn first aid in the case of emergency. If the drug user is unconscious, place him in the recovery position and make sure that the airway is clear. Injecting drug is much more harmful than other ways of taking drugs. Never let anyone drive or operate any machinery under the influence of alcohol or drugs. Try to enroll the addicts into a drug treatment and rehabilitation center and help them start a new life through de-addiction. Thank you.